Hi everyone, Miss Melinda here, your spiritual worker from MissMelindasMetaphysicalServices.com. You can find me all over the web by searching Miss Melinda's Metaphysical Services. And today I'm here to talk to you a little bit about a little witch's bottle, a container spell that I have made for the purpose of protection from enemies. So this is a traditional witch's bottle, but it's also considered a container spell because it's a spell within a container, a spell within a bottle. And to make this protection against enemies witch's bottle, I started with a photograph of the enemy in question. And let me be clear that when I define enemy, I am defining somebody who is actively doing harm against other people, somebody who is actively trying to harm your finances or your family, someone who is hindering your life in a way that is detrimental, hindering your employment, hindering your income, taking your property, causing havoc in your relationships, or trying to harm you, your relationships, or your family, right? So a serious enemy. And I started with a photo of the enemy, and in order to help me hone in on my intentions and to help me focus in on the overall energy of this work, I used pins, little straight pins, to poke holes in the photograph of the enemy. And as I poke the holes, I'm stating my intention, and I state my intention until that intention becomes a powerful chant, and until I build up a rhythm and really focus in on and achieve a flow with the rhythm of that chant, really bringing the power of my intention through my voice and using the energy of my action as well as the energy of my voice to build energy and direct it towards the work and towards the target. So while I'm poking the holes, I'm stating things like, your behavior is bound, your behavior is impotent, your actions are null and void, you are no longer able to harm, you are hindered, you are bound, you are banished. Things of this nature until becomes a fluid, powerful chant. And then after stating those intentions and imbuing the photo and the target with that energy, sending that energy off to the target, then we burn the photo completely to ash in a fireproof container. I do recommend that you do that near a window, an open window with some fresh air. If you've ever burned a photograph, then you'll know it's quite toxic. You don't want to breathe in those fumes. Also, so when you're by an open window, be careful that you're not scattering the ashes of the photo around your space. You want to contain the energy of this work. You want to be sure that you're not scattering energy all around and that you're not influencing the rest of your space or other work with the energy of this work. So you want to keep it contained. Be careful about that. And so then the ashes, when the photo is burned totally to ashes, right? Make sure it's completely burned up. And then you add the ashes to the bottle. And to those ashes, I have also added straight black pepper. Black pepper is amazing for banishing. It's amazing for protection. It's a very potent ingredient to use in work such as this. To the black pepper, I have also added some graveyard dust or graveyard dirt. And the dirt that I have added is actually dirt from the grave of an ancestor. And the reason that I use dirt from the grave of an ancestor is because this is an ancestor that is close to me. This is an ancestor that I work closely with. And this is a family matter that I'm dealing with here. This is a protection from enemies on behalf of a family member of mine who's being attacked by somebody else. So this ancestor of mine is especially helpful and especially pertinent in this situation because this ancestor would be concerned about our mutual family member as well. So when you're using graveyard dust or dirt, you do want to be conscientious of the reason that you're using it. You want to have just as much intent behind that as you would any other ingredient. And to that, I have also added rusty nails. Rusty nails are a very powerful ingredient in traditional witch bottles, especially for protection or for banishing. So you may be able to see some of those nails a little bit through the other ingredients there. There are several rusty nails in here. I added 9. 9 is a powerful magical number that I like to work with. And then after that, I just shake the bottle. I shook the bottle quite a bit while thinking about my intentions, while raising energy and sending energy to this work, sending energy into this bottle. And then after that, I went ahead and sealed the work. I sealed the work by using a nail to nail across into the top of the bottle. You can see it there. It's just a little cross charm. A cross is a powerful protective symbol regardless of what religion you affiliate with. A cross has always been a symbol of protection long before Christianity began to use the symbol. And a cross has a lot of special meaning in all kinds of folk magic practices as well. A cross is representative of the crossroads. It is representative of the place where the magic takes place, the place between the worlds, the place between this world and the next world, where the magic takes place, where we're able to convene with the spirit world, where we're able to walk between worlds, where we're able to draw forth the spiritual support needed to accomplish our work or to assist us with accomplishing our work. So a cross is a powerful symbol in many, many different ways. And after sealing this work with the nail and the cross, I placed this bottle on my ancestor altar and I lit a candle in dedication to my ancestors as an offering. And I said some prayers to them, asking them for continued support with this work, stating my intentions, and continuing to direct and channel energy into this work in conjunction with my ancestors. And at a later date, I then gave my ancestors an additional offering of spirit money. And again, I burnt that spirit money up to ash. And then I added the ashes of that spirit money to this witch's bottle as well. So the fresher ashes on top are actually from the spirit money. I've been shaking this quite a lot, so you're probably not going to be able to see specific defined layers in this, but you can see that there are some different kinds of ashes, some rocks, some graveyard dirt, and some different ingredients here. So that's it. It's pretty basic. It's pretty simple, but just like anything else, it's the energy and the intent that you put into it that is really going to give it its power and that's really going to work that magic. And one of the most traditional ways to work a bottle like this is to shake it and add energy to it and raise energy while you're shaking it and really reinforce your intentions through visualization or through chanting or through energy while you are shaking it. That's how you work a bottle like this. So I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope it's helpful for you. Feel free to let me know if you have any questions. And be well. Stay blessed. Thank you.